Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia Optima guys. And you need to remove or replace intake runner control solenoid or intake runner control actuator guys. Stay with us, we'll explain how to remove them, how to replace them, where they're located, and we'll explain how you can actually even test them, find out if they're working or not. All that will be covered in this video today. So, this should work on Kia Optima guys, generation 2010 all the way to year 2015-16 with a 2.4 GDI engine guys. If you have one of those, it will cover that. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. We take them completely apart and we show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. If you need to buy tools, parts for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our tools and supplies from. So with that being said, this is the engine right here. We have the 2.4 GDI engine that we'll be demonstrating on. So if you look at that engine guys, okay, with the engine out, we can clearly show you with a great detail. But if you look right here at the engine now, that's the intake manifold on the left side of the engine by the belts. Be careful. Never do anything on running engine guys, because you can get your fingers in the belts and cut them off. So if you look at it right here, that's the intake runner actuator. That underneath is intake runner solenoid. So there is a vacuum line, okay, that comes all the way from here guys, okay, all the way from here next to the throttle body, goes behind the intake manifold. We have a special video that explains how to remove intake manifold. Check it out if you want to. There is multiple vacuum lines that go on the back side, and right here that vacuum line comes to the intake runner solenoid guys. So that solenoid will open when you have enough vacuum, and it will actually control that actuator that will move, okay, the intake runner valves, okay, closed or open or in a different angle. Now, if you have problems with those, it could be a vacuum leak. That's actually the number one thing. Number two, it could be a bad solenoid or a bad actuator. So let's explain how to remove and replace them. Right here now, okay, we're going to disconnect the wire by pressing down here, okay, and pulling like that. Here you're going to, okay, this wire, we pulled it out of here. You don't need to, but it will give us a little bit more room. Now, with a clip removal tool, we're going to get here, again, remove the ball joint. Just be careful. Okay, perfect, like that. You pry more on this side, because if you're on this, you can break it. Now, the actuator, guys, is with 10 millimeter bolts, two bolts. So let's go ahead and do that. And we'll have a video on our channel that will explain how to test intake runner actuator. Bolt number two. Okay, that mount fell here, you have to be careful. Now, the intake runner solenoid right here will have one bolt underneath, okay, over there. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Perfect. Careful not to drop the bolt, and now you pull it out. So that's how you guys remove them. You can see intake runner solenoid, that's what opens and closes the vacuum, that's what moves the intake runner guys right here, that actuator. So if you want to see how to test them, the video will be on the channel. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.